the economics completely changes. You don't have to print the same textbook. Actually convert the whole thing into a library exercise. Why shouldn't the first and second grade, including the kindergarten, if you will, just become a library? I don't understand why it cannot be done. It cannot be done because we are not ready for it. But I don't see why we should not be able to experiment it. If you guarantee that at the end of this stage, all these children will be able to read and do the basics of arithmetic and all those things that this curriculum demands, why shouldn't this be possible? And I think Akshara is well placed to try something out like this. Having done so many things with the government, maybe you should try it out and say, okay, we will actually create a library atmosphere where from day one, all we'll do is read to children and make them tell us stories and make them tell us things about shapes and things about numbers and the things that they counted on the way. And we build a whole different atmosphere in the class, which is class 1, 2, 3. Maybe the fifth standard children also will want to come and sit with you and learn to do something completely different. And all these children will do well in any given exam, according to me. It doesn't have to be given, because we know that standardized exams, kids who have learned to deal with questions independently, they can solve. We are not teaching estimation in schools at all. If I ask you, what's the height of this room? Any guesses? Yeah, now you see the spread. That actually, this is a lesson in statistics as well. So, if you do a simple thing like that, you try doing this in a classroom and you see what happens. First of all, feet, meter, everything starts going all together. And that alone is an exercise in a huge learning, and you don't worry about a thing after the kids have taken charge. So I personally feel that if we start thinking differently about what we want out of education, and if we define those outcomes, then, and if we accept those outcomes, then there is a huge opportunity right now to do something majorly different in transforming schools in a big way. The role of the teacher and what the teacher should be doing. We have been practicing in other areas what we call the Kamal method. Actually, it's spelled like camel. Combination of activities for maximized learning. So we made it into a Kamal. And what we found was that the idea behind that was not just say reading. Okay, not just reading and writing. Because when you let loose a slogan like Read India, then everybody says read. And then you forget that reading requires speaking also. So now we've done many things that involve children doing multiple activities. If you read something, then you must write it. If you say something, then show where it is or things like that. So you combine different activities. And we transferred this to some schools. The teachers were very happy to do this in Pune district, in one block, teachers are trying this. In many other places, in Punjab, I think it was tried out and so on. But the funny thing is, after that, one class is over, they go back to sitting in rows. Until then, it is just fine. I notice in English also, I don't know whether it's your observation or not, when you do English training, the teachers, whether it's men or women, they're happy to sort of dance and shake their, you know what. But when you start telling them that you have to do all these activities when you have to teach math, no, it's a very serious affair. So in doing math, so this is actually a Trojan horse as far as I'm concerned. The reason I would like to promote a lot of English is when you do this English, people are willing to do just about anything because it is foreign. And it is foreign, then I can always shake. But if it is Indian, then our culture doesn't allow such things. Our culture only wants the Guru Shishya Parampara of a different kind that we don't know about. So, I think interesting that there should be many openings available. But my fear is that the way the Right to Education Act sometimes is driven and the way it is being done today, it may create many more obstacles than required. Because then you don't know what continuous comprehensive evaluation is, and yet you are saying no assessment, no examinations. All kinds of things can happen. We don't even know what we have to evaluate. What is exactly, if you really go down deep into it, what is continuous comprehensive evaluation, it can create a lot of trouble. We really don't know what it is. So, all in all, to conclude my key, and it's your note after this. No, I have decided that I'm not going to speak for 25 minutes. You're going to have a problem on your hand.